Testing, 1, 2, testing. Testing, 1, 2. Testing, 1, 2, testing, 1, 2.
Blessed is our God, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Heavenly peace, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Most Reverend Archbishop and Father Savas, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and all the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the servants of God, Nico, and the handmaiden of God, Alyssa, who now pledge themselves to one another, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That there may descend upon them perfect and peaceful love and the help of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That they may be preserved and blessed in concord and sound faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, in your grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, and with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
You, O Lord.
For to you, our glory, honor, worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Everlasting God, those who were divided you brought into oneness, setting for them an unbreakable bond of love. You blessed Isaac and Rebekah and made their heirs to your promise. Bless these, your servants, Nicholas and Alessa, guiding them into every good work. You are a merciful and loving God, and to you we give the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen.
Irene Pasi, peace be with all of you.
And to your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before you, O Lord.
For you, O Lord.
O Lord, our God, you espouse the church as a pure virgin, calling out from it the Gentiles. Lord, we pray at this very moment to bless this betrothal, uniting these, your servants, Nicholas and Alyssa, keeping them in peace and in oneness of mind. For to you are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, both now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, our God, when the servant of the patriarch Abraham was sent into Mesopotamia to seek a wife for his master Isaac, you walked with him. Through the meeting at the well, you revealed to him that he should engage Rebekah. Will you now, Lord, bless the betrothal of your servants, Nicholas and Elisa, and confirm the word they have given? Establish them in that sacred oneness that rests in you. For in the beginning you made them man and woman. And it is by you that woman is joined to man, to support one another and to perpetuate humankind. As you sent forth your truth to your inheritance, making your covenant with your servants, our fathers, your chosen ones in every generation, look on these your servants, Nicholas and Elisa, and ground their betrothal firmly in faith and oneness of mind, in truth, and in love. For you, Lord, have made your will clear, that a pledge should be given and confirmed by every means. By a ring, authority was given to Joseph in Egypt. Daniel was honored with a ring in the land of Babylon. By a ring, the uprightness of Tamar was manifested. With a ring, our heavenly Father displayed mercy for the prodigal son. For he said, put a ring on his hand, and bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry. Your own right hand, Lord, armed Moses in the Red Sea. By the word of your truth were the heavens established and the foundations of the earth made firm.
and the right hands of your servants shall likewise be blessed by your mighty word and your upraised arm. Now then, Lord, bless this giving of grace with a heavenly blessing, and may the angel of the Lord lead them all the days of their life. For it is you who bless and sanctify all things, and to you we offer the glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are all those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you.
For you shall enjoy the fruits of your labors. Blessed are you, and all shall be well with you.
Glory to you, our God.
Life shall be like a fruitful vine on the walls of your house, your children like newly planted olive trees round about your table.
O exousi, O Theos, imon, O exousi.
See, thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion, and may you enjoy the blessings of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Glory to you, our God. Glory to you.
May you see your children's children. Peace be on Israel.
Glory to you, our God.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Heavenly peace, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Ελθύσιν ἐν Ἰησοῦς ἡμᾶν τοῦς κόσμου ἐσταθείας τὸν Αγίων τοῦ Θεοκλησίων καὶ τοῦς πάντων ενώσεως τοῦ Κυρίου δεϊθόμεν.
Lord, have mercy.
Του Αγίου Οικοτούτου και μεταβίσες ευλαβίας και φόβου Θεού Ισιών τον εναυτό του Κυρίου δεϊθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For our most reverend Archbishop and Father Savas, for the venerable priests of the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and all the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the servant of God, Nicholas, and the handmaiden of God, Alyssa, who are now being joined to one another in the community of the Holy Marriage, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That this marriage may be blessed, as was the one in Cana of Galilee, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
They may be granted mature judgment and children for their benefit. Let us pray to the Lord.
them and us in every petition, bearing our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That they and we may be spared from all affliction, wrath, danger, and want, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us. Keep us, O God, in your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
And bring our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady the Theotokos and ever-Virgin
most
Mary,
holy
with
Theotokos
all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
We owe, O Lord.
For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, most pure, the maker of all creation, in your love for man, you transformed the rib of our forefather Adam into woman, and blessed them and said, "Be fruitful and multiply, and have dominion over the earth." And you made the two of them one flesh through union. For this reason shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his own wife, and the two shall be one flesh, and those whom God has yoked together, let no one separate. You blessed your servant Abraham by granting Sarah offspring and made them the parents of many nations. You gave Isaac to Rebekah and blessed their child. You joined Jacob to Rachel and from him brought forth the 12 patriarchs. You united Joseph and Asenath and granted them Ephraim and Manasseh as offspring. You responded to Zacharias and Elizabeth and made their son the forerunner and Baptist John. From the root of Jesse you brought forth in the flesh the ever-Virgin Mary, from which you became incarnate and were born for the salvation of the human race. In your inexpressible grace and great goodness, you traveled to Cana of Galilee and blessed the wedding there, in order to show that lawful union and the procreation of children from it are indeed your will. Do you, all-holy Master, accept the prayer of us, your supplicants, and as you were with them, be here also with us through your invisible presence. Bless this marriage and grant to your servants Nicholas and Alyssa a tranquil life, long years, mature judgment, love for each other in the bond of peace, long-lasting posterity, grace on their children, a crown of everlasting glory. Make them worthy to see their children's children. Preserve their marital bed undefiled, and bestow upon them the dew of heaven from above and all the riches of the earth. Fill their home with wheat, wine, and oil, and with every good thing, so that they may give to those in need, and grant to those here present all their requests that lead to salvation. For you are the God of mercy and compassion and love, and to you we send up glory, together with your Father, who is without beginning, and your all-holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Blessed are you, O Lord, our God, celebrant of the mystical and pure marriage, lawgiver of the marriage of the body, guardian of incorruption, and righteous steward of the gifts of this life. In the beginning, O Master, you created man and established him as the king of creation and said, "It is not good that man should be alone on the earth. Let us make a helper fit for him." And taking one of his ribs, you formed a woman. And when Adam saw her, he said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of her man. For this reason shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his own wife, and the two shall be one flesh."
and those whom God has yoked together, let no man separate. You now, Lord and Master, our God, send down your heavenly grace upon your servants Nicholas and Alyssa, and grant that this maiden may in all things submit to the man, and that this your servant may be the head of the woman, so that they may live according to your will. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Abraham and Sarah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Isaac and Rebekah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Jacob and all the patriarchs. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Joseph and Asenath. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Moses and Zipporah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Joachim and Anna. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Zechariah and Elizabeth. Guard them, O Lord our God, as you guarded Noah in the ark, Jonah in the belly of the whale, and the three holy youths from the fire, by sending down upon them dew from heaven. And let there come upon them that great joy which the blessed Helena felt when she found the precious cross. Remember them, O Lord our God, as you remembered Enoch, Shem, and Elias, as you remembered your holy 40 martyrs on whom you sent down crowns from heaven. Remember, O Lord our God, the parents who brought them up, for the blessing of parents make firm the foundations of homes. Remember, O Lord our God, your servants, the attendants, who you have come together to share this rejoicing. Remember, O Lord our God, your servant Nicholas and your servant Alyssa, and bless them. Grant them the fruit of the womb, bear children, oneness of souls and bodies. Exalt them as the cedars of Lebanon, as a luxuriant vine. Graciously give to them the fullness of blessings, so that being sufficient in everything, they may abound in every good work that is acceptable to you, and may see their children's children like newly planted olive trees round about their table. And having pleased you in every way, they may shine as the stars of heaven in you, our Lord, to whom are due all glory, dominion, honor, and worship, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy God, you formed man out of earth, then fashioned woman out of his flesh, and joined her to him as a helpmeet. For it seemed good to your majesty that man would not be alone on earth. Now too, Master, reach out your hand from your holy dwelling place and conjoin these your servants, Nicholas and Alyssa. For by you is the woman married to the man. Unite them in one mind, wed them into one body, and grant them fruitful issue, the delight of your fair children. For yours is the dominion, and yours the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Servant of God, Nicholas, is crowned in marriage. The handmaid of God, Alyssa. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The servant of God, Nicholas, is crowned in marriage. To the handmaid of God, Alyssa. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The servant of God, Nicholas, is crowned in marriage. To the handmaid of God, listen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Handmaid of God, Alyssa, is crowned in marriage to the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Handmaid of God, Alyssa, is crowned in marriage to the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The handmaid of God, Alyssa, is crowned in marriage to the servant of God, Nicholas, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison, doxa και τιμή, στεφάνος ον αυτού.
You have set upon their heads crowns of precious stones. They asked life of you, and you gave it to them. The reading is from the epistle of the holy apostle Paul to the Ephesians. Wisdom,
let us be attentive.
Brethren, give thanks always for all things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to God the Father. Be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, be subjects to your husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. As the church is subject to Christ, so let wives be also subject in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives, as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of the water with the word, that he might present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. Even so, husbands should love your wives as your own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no man ever hates his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. This is a great mystery, and I take it to mean Christ and the church. However, let each one of you love his wife as himself. She respects her husband.
Peace be to you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, arise, let Let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
At that time, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Now both Jesus and his disciples were invited to the wedding. And when they ran out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said to her, "Lady, what is that to you and me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Whatsoever he says to you, do it." Now there were set there 6 water pots of stone, according to the manner of the purification of the Jews, containing 20 or 30 gallons apiece. Jesus said to them, "Fill the water pots with water," and they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Draw some out now and take it to the steward of the feast." And they took it. When the steward of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, "Every man at the beginning sets out the good wine, and when the guests have drunk well, then the inferior. But you have kept the good wine until now." This, the beginning of the mysteries of Jesus, he did in Cana of Galilee, and manifested his glory. And his disciples believed in him.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you. Let us say with our whole souls and all our mind, let us say, O Lord, Almighty God of our fathers, we pray you, listen and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Mercy, life, peace, health, salvation for the servants of God, Nicholas and Alyssa, the newlyweds, along with their attendants, parents, relatives, and all here present. We pray to you, hear us and have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
For you are a merciful God, and to you we send up glory, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord our God, who in your saving dispensation declared marriage honorable by your presence in Cana of Galilee, keep in peace and concord your servants Nicholas and Alyssa, whom you have been pleased to join together. Cause their marriage to be honorable. Preserve their marital bed undefiled. Grant that they may live together without spot of sin, and make them worthy to attain a ripe old age, fulfilling your commandments with a pure heart. For you are our God, the God of mercy and salvation, and to you we ascribe glory, together with your Father, who is without beginning, in your all-holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Make us, worthy Master, that with confidence and without fear of reproach, to make bold to call you the Heavenly God, Father, and to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Yours name is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Irini Pasi, peace be with all.
As with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
To you, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, who made all things by your power and established the world and adorned the crown of everything that you made, bless with a spiritual blessing this common cup which you offer to those joined in marriage. For your name is blessed and your kingdom is glorified, of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
I will drink of the cup of salvation, and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
magnified, O bridegroom like Abraham, and be blessed like Isaac, and multiply like Jacob, walking in peace and fulfilling in righteousness the commandments of God. And you, O bride, be glorified like Sarah, be glad like Rebecca, and multiply like Rachel, rejoicing in your own husband and observing the requirements of the law, for so God is well pleased.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, our God, who went to Cana of Galilee and blessed the wedding there, bless also these your servants who by your providence have been joined together in the community of matrimony. Bless their goings out, their comings in. Grant them a life full of good things. Take up their crowns. Into your kingdom and preserve them undefiled, blameless and beyond reproach through the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with all.
And to your spirit.
Let us bow our heads to the Lord.
To you, Lord.
May the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the all-holy and consubstantial and life-giving Trinity, the one Godhead and kingdom, bless you and grant to you long life, beautiful children, progress in life and growth in faith, enrich you with all the good things of the earth, and make you worthy to enjoy the blessings promised to us through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints. Glory to you, our God and our hope. Glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Holy Master, pray a blessing.
May Christ, our true God, who by his coming to Cana in Galilee rendered marriage honorable, through the intercessions of his all-pure mother, of the whole glorious and all-praised apostles, of the holy, God-crowned rulers, equal to the apostles Constantine and Helen, of the holy great martyr Procopius, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good God who loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save
us.
Got to get them first. Now you can express an expression. Express your love for one another in a chaste and appropriate manner.
Reverence. Reverend Fathers.
I can speak longer.
Again, Your Eminence, thank you for allowing me the opportunity to say a few words to Nico and Alyssa. Whenever two or three are gathered in my name, I am in their midst. Obviously a verse that you know both very well. I look around, I see so many of your family members, of your fellow classmates from Holy Cross. And you have certainly surrounded yourself with those who share with you the same love of Christ that you do. And that is something very important for you to remember, not just today, but for the rest of your lives. We gather today to say prayers on your behalf. And one of the first prayers that we said was this one, that the Lord will send down upon them perfect and peaceful love. And that's what we all pray for both of you. Perfect and peaceful love. How does one define that? Christ taught us what that means. You already know what that means. Because of the love that you share, and because of your studies, and because of your families, because that's how they raised you. Someone might say that a perfect love, how does it go? No greater love than when one gives their life for another. We all know what that means, but there's another meaning to that as well. It's not a physical demise of the other party. It's giving of oneself. You are no longer individuals. You are becoming one. And so you will give, as your parents know, and as well as your parents know, and all the other parents and married couples that are in here. There will be sacrifices that will be made. And you'll make those out of your love. Not because you have to, but you make it out of love. And that's when it's truly strong, and that's when it truly has meaning. The other part of that prayer that we said, guarding them in oneness of mind and steadfast faith. As time progresses, you'll finish each other's sentences, maybe even each other's thoughts, but that's part of your life together. You will grow together and become so close that you truly become one. Steadfast faith. I feel comfortable speaking on behalf of both sets of parents here. You were born and raised in your faith and grew in your faith. And with respect to your studies and all those that you have surrounded yourselves with, your faith is very strong. And we pray that it continues to be strong. Because in the world that we live in, there are so many challenges. Challenges not just to your marriage, but challenges to your faith as well. A faithful person has a cross to carry. Now, both of you will carry that cross together. The crowns that were placed on your head, with the grace of God, with your parents, with your friends and your family, those crowns will remain forever, and they will never fade. Bless you. Your Eminence, thank you.
Thank you, Father. I am grateful to God that He created an opportunity for me to be here at the 11th hour. I had thought that I couldn't be here because I will be marrying the son of my best friend tomorrow afternoon, and he had booked it well in advance of your wedding. But I was so torn, and I thought, how can I leave Alyssa without a bishop at her wedding? So I made the necessary plans, and I will be driving myself after this service straight away to New Jersey so I can be present for that wedding tomorrow. And I'll rest easy knowing that I got to be here for this wonderful moment in your lives. I love the fact that the church calls these significant moments mysteries. We can use the word sacrament. There's nothing wrong with the word sacrament, but it's less deep. Sacrament is almost like code, you know? It's like this stands for this, almost. But mystery is deeper than that. Mystery means, I can't explain it. I think we misuse the word mystery most of the time because we use it in reference to murders, you know, the solution of a murder mystery. That's not really Mysteries aren't solved. Mysteries are revealed. Problems are solved. But mysteries are revealed. That's the ancient sense of it anyway. The Greek word mysterion comes from the Greek word to shut your lips. Mysteries aren't spoken about. Mysteries are experienced. Only somebody on the other side of the mystery, only an initiate, can tell you what the mystery is about. Okay? Everybody else is on the outside. So we have a mystery of baptism. We have a mystery of the Eucharist. We have a mystery of ordination. We have the mystery of healing. We have the mystery of matrimony. And in a sense, it's a mystery I'm locked out of. You know, I've chosen a different life's path. You're going to enter into something that only experience will reveal. Your mystery will be revealed in the living out of your marriage. But at the heart of all the mysteries is the mystery of love. And I have an intuition of what love is. We're all groping for a better understanding. And praying that in time we'll understand love ever better and better throughout eternity. But love can't be exhausted. Love isn't a static thing. Love is something that will always have more to tell us and more to reveal to us. What I know about love is that the one who loves doesn't count the cost. The one who loves gives entirely to the loved one. The one who loves doesn't tally things up. You know, I did this, now you owe me. It's none of that. It's all free gifts. It's all just living for the other. I also know that love may look like dying to some people. I mean, love means pouring out of oneself. It may look foolish, you know, it doesn't seem to serve the ego. You know, it's more than that. And yet the mystery of love is that love, out of this self-emptying, creates. That out of, when you live for another person, something comes out of that, something new. We're here to witness the beginning of a new creation. You guys are creating a new reality, a family. And that, a loving family, can't help but be a creative reality. You know, one way it expresses itself is in the creation of children, if God blesses that. But there's also, you know, there is no, if a marriage, if the married couple only lives for themselves, there's something wrong with that. Love reaches out beyond itself. The energy of a marriage affects the community, the church. You know, I mean, I love the fact that the church said, the church is blessing you with all good things so that you can do all good things. It's not just for your sake. It's so that out of your abundance, you can give. You can give witness, at first and foremost, witness to the creative power of love. Witness, another good Greek word, martyrdom. We sang songs when we were going around that table referring to martyrs. And you know, there's plenty of jokes waiting in that, you know. Marriage as martyrdom, you know. But marriage is martyrdom. And not because of the pain involved, but because that it's meant to bear witness to the creative power of selfless love. When one looks at a married couple that's married in Christ, one sees and one marvels because their life bears witness. We expect that of your lives. Because I'm not telling you anything you don't know. I'm not telling you anything new. You were raised with this understanding. And I rejoice in that. It's one of the challenges of a pastor to marry people of all degrees of faith. You know, sometimes you meet the married couple as they're standing in front of you, you know, or in the days leading up to the wedding, because they're doing it for a variety of reasons, to make their parents happy, because it's expected, for whatever reason. It's wonderful when there are children of faith here who are here so that we can all pray for you, that you may do, that you may enter into a new way of being in Christ. My heart is full. My heart is full. Well, mystery means to shut your lips. And so, I'll conclude with two blessings. One that we heard time and again. Well, no, one is an ancient Greek blessing. Vion anthosparton, may your life's path be strewn with flowers. But one is an ancient Jewish blessing that we heard time and again in today's service, and one that says so much. And I love to say it. I can't say it enough. May you see your children's children. Peace. God bless you. You know, can I kiss you again? Many years to you. And we said, the blessings of parents make firm the foundations of homes. So I ask that you greet your parents now who made all this possible. You can start with this one here.
inspires me to start studying again. How do you improve? Because I can get by being an orphan by myself. But now I want to improve again. You inspire me. That was so nice. When is yours again?
Five Saturdays.
Picture real quick. Thank you.